Hi everyone, welcome to DMR tutorials. In the previous capsules, we have discussed about the force, types of force and nature of force and all the things. In this capsule, let us discuss about what do you mean by thrust and what do you mean by force, pressure. So the topic for us now is about thrust and pressure. First of all, let us see what do you mean by thrust. For example, AB is a surface. It may be the surface of a table. On this surface, so I have placed a book. Table, on the surface of table, I have placed a book. And book has certain mass. Mass multiplied by acceleration due to gravity gives you the weight. The weight of the book always acts vertically in the downward direction. Weight of the body always acts vertically in the downward direction. The weight of the book acts on this surface. The weight of the book acts on the surface of the table vertically in the downward direction. Then the weight of the body itself is called as thrust. Basically, the meaning of thrust is the force acted upon a body normal to the surface of the body is called thrust. Here you see, again let us take another surface. This is a body on the surface, as usual AB. On this surface, F1, F2, and F3. Three forces are acting on the body. F1, F3 are not perpendicular, whereas F2 is acting on the surface normally. Then this force F2 is called thrust. Remaining F1, F3 are simply the forces. They are not thrust. So if you want to call a force as thrust, the force should act on the surface of the body normally. So the force acting on the surface of a body normal to its surface itself is called as thrust. The difference between the thrust and force is that particular angle. F1, F3 are simply the forces. They are not thrust. F2, which acts on the surface with 90 degrees normally, that we will call it as thrust. So a force acting on a body normal to its surface is called thrust. So basically, thrust and force are the same. The difference is almost the same. The difference is the angle. With what angle the force is acting on the body, that decides the thrust. Now, what are the unit? Whatever the unit for force, the same are the units for thrust. MKS unit is Newton. And CGS unit is time. So the next topic is about the pressure. What do you mean by pressure? The definition of pressure is thrust per unit area thrust per unit area is called pressure. So pressure P is equal to thrust F by area of contact A. Otherwise, P is equal to F by A. What are the units for it? The MKS unit is force is Newton, area is meter square. So Newtons per meter square is the unit of pressure in MKS system, whereas in CGS dyne per centimeter square. So dyne per centimeter square is the unit of pressure in CGS system. There are other units also there for pressure. Atmospheres. Millimeters of mercury heights. So there are other units to measure the pressure. So different units are there. These are the main units. Atmospheres and millimeters of mercury height. And there are the other units for pressure. So let us see what are the factors affecting the pressure acting on a surface. So for pressure is equal to force by area. Force is in the numerator, area is in the denominator. In other words, pressure is directly proportional to force. The more is the force applied, the greater is the pressure. That means there is the direct variation. And pressure is inversely proportional to area of contact. The more is the area of contact, the lesser is the pressure. The less is the area of contact, the greater is the pressure. Suppose, let us take a cuboid. This is a solid cuboid. When it is placed on a surface, suppose its length is 20 centimeters, breadth is 15 centimeters, height is 10 centimeters, say. It has three surfaces. One, two, and three. So, first surface means 20 into 15 is the area of first surface. 15 into 10 is the area of second surface. 20 into 10 is the area of third surface. So when the object is placed in three different positions, it causes different pressures. Thrust is the same, weight of the body is the same. But when you change the surface, then the pressure will change. So, if a solid block is kept on a surface, the pressure, the thrust is the same, but the pressure acting on the surface depends upon the area of contact. Suppose this is the body. If I keep the body like this, the area is bit more, so pressure is less. If I put like this, area is very less, the pressure is very high. If I put like this, area is moderate, and the pressure is also moderate. So, the pressure acting on a surface due to a solid body depends upon the area of contact between the body and the surface. So, this is about the pressure of a solid on a surface. That's it, this capsule. I am signing off.